Hello, today I'm also going to share to you on how to make this beautiful textured stitch. It is still a herringbone pattern, however, one row is embossed than the other row. So, I don't know if you can clearly see it from the camera, but as you can see, this is bumpy than this layer. But if you turn it to the other side, it does look the same. The pattern looks the same. Okay, so I'm going to call this a herringbone pattern with alternating embossed layers. So I have here an even number of stitch. Currently I'm using this cord foundation stitch. You may check my other videos on how to make foundation stitch. You can choose cord or chainless, or the one with chain and a row of single crochet. So it doesn't really matter, you can choose whatever foundation stitch you would like. Okay, so now we have an even number of stitch. Then chain one and turn. Now on our first stitch, is just before our chain, we do a slip stitch. Okay, then yarn over, then insert the hook on the same stitch and pull up a loop. Then yarn over, insert the hook on the next stitch and pull up another loop. So now you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 loops. Then pull through all loops. Then we do a slip stitch on the next stitch. Okay, then yarn over, insert the hook on the same stitch that we did the slip, then yarn over, and insert the hook on the following stitch. And we pull up one loop. Now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 loops. Pull through all 5 loops. And then we do a slip stitch. Once again, yarn over, insert the hook on the same stitch that we did a slip, pull up one loop. Then yarn over, insert the hook on the following stitch, pull up one loop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 loops in the hook and pull through all loops and slip stitch. Okay. Again. Okay, we are down to the end of our row. So we end the row with a, because we no longer have a stitch after this, then we just make a chain one. Okay, then we turn and then this is a one row repeat. So we'll be doing again turn over. Okay. Again. Okay, we are again down at the end of the row. And so since there is no stitch after this one to make our slip, we do chain one and then turn. See, there you go. So it's an alternating emboss for our bumps of the herringbone pattern. So just like that, after you turn, so you just repeat the same step, yarn over, insert the hook, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull up another loop, and pull through all 5 loops, and then slip stitch, then yarn over, insert the hook and pull up 1 loop on the same stitch that we did our slip, and then yarn over, pull up another loop on the next stitch, pull through all 5 loops, and then slip stitch. Okay, okay, there you go. So I hope you learned from this tutorial. I hope you like and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.